have children and adults who die every day needing some sort of functional tissue. Can that be built and replaced and regenerated by stem cells? We think the answer is yes.
The critical place where I think stem cell research will have a kind of life-altering impact will be in the area of regenerative medicine. There will be ways that we can approach treating patients that could not have really been thought of in traditional small molecule pharmacology.
I think there's a number of different things that we're going to get from stem cell research. I think maybe one of the earliest benefits is going to be how our understanding of normal stem cells will inform cancer therapy.
I think it's given us some fundamental insights into cancer that we wouldn't have seen otherwise, and pathways to attack, and probably most importantly, combinations of pathways to attack that we wouldn't have seen unless we took this stem cell approach.
The ultimate goal of stem cell research, of course, is that we will develop regenerative therapies. Now that's when we're talking about using normal stem cells or some kind of cells that we can turn into normal stem cells to replace organs that are damaged or lost or that stop working as we age. And those therapies, I think, are the great promise of stem cell research because that promises to deliver therapies that are much less toxic and more permanent.
Really, the potential of stem cell biology and regenerative medicine, I think, is far greater than we ever anticipated. We have the ability to reprogram cells from every individual to get information about genetic impacts of drugs, to make neurons or heart cells or liver cells from anybody. Just a simple example is we're beginning to understand human development and how errors occur. And if you can understand how the errors occur, you can diagnose and you can probably begin to treat more specifically in a personalized manner.
Stanford is special as a place for stem cell biology for the following reasons. We have one of the largest, or if not the largest, physical building dedicated to stem cell biology in the world, but that's just the hub. It's how we connect our science to the other seven schools and what the other seven schools bring to our stem cell program.
If you really want to solve a problem, I think that's the best way to do it, to get a lot of relatively smart people together, working together to try to advance a project rather than competing with each other. And I think that is very, very strong here at Stanford and the Stem Cell Institute.
I'm a physician scientist. I see patients as part of my clinical practice on the faculty here at Stanford, and I find it entirely motivating to go and take care of patients and remind, not that you need to really be reminded, but hit it home even harder, what it is we're doing here, why it is that we're working on these research projects.
My clinical activities very strongly impact my desire to do research and to improve treatments. So clinically, I focus on treating lung cancer patients, which is the number one cancer killer, and a disease for which we desperately need better treatments. When I go to clinic, I have patients who have their cancer spread and often eventually will die of their cancer. And if you have a personal relationship with patients, that really drives you to want to improve treatments for them.
It is true that we're at probably at the beginning of stem cell biology and regenerative medicine as far as the full potential, but every year it becomes more and more clear that we had not imagined how important this field was actually going to be.